Hello all, welcome back to Anything Channel. In today's video, let's discuss about throttle faults in your e-bike. First, let me explain about how the throttle works and regarding for the models, what is the difference between them. So this one is a thumb throttle. So basically, we have two components inside here. One is the Hall effect sensor, that is this small electronic component, and as well we have this magnet here. So the principle of works, basically we have the sensor in the position, and then when we move the throttle, this magnet will change the position, and as a result we'll have a voltage variation in the output of the sensor. As you can see, most of the e-bike throttles have three wires. That is because the Hall effect sensor as well have three wires. Of these three wires, we have one that is the positive of the power source, also the negative, and the third one is the output of the sensor. This will be that will generate the voltage variation that will be responsible for move the motor proportionally as you select, as you push the throttle. Okay, so talking about the power supply of this sensor, let's say that most of the e-bike controllers works with 5 volts in the throttle. So of these two wires, if you measure with the multimeter, this the positive and the negative of the sensor, we will have 5 volts. Okay, so despite of the type of sensor, let's say like this one, all works with the same principle, all with a Hall effect sensor and as well with a magnet. You may have this connector here that have more than 3 pins, sometimes come with separate connectors like this one. This is because usually you have together with the throttle one more function, like a switch, for example this one, or also you can have all in the same connectors. For example, we have 2 pins, 2 wires for the switch, and also other 3 for the throttle. Okay, but what is the voltage that you expect to have in the throttle? So to check this, you need to use a multimeter. Okay, this one I connect directly in my e-bike, so we will see the real voltage that is generated by this throttle. So first you need to power up the e-bike in the LCD. Let's turn on. Now we can see that in initial position of the throttle we have almost 0.8 volts. So without any push or any twist in the throttle, we have 0.8. This voltage is important, especially for the controller detects if the throttle is working or not. Let's say that you have some cable broke, we don't have this voltage, and then we have some error indicating in the display. So basically when you thrust, when you twist the throttle, you can see that you have the voltage increasing. This is generated by the Hall effect sensor because we are movement the magnet inside here in front of the Hall effect sensor. Then you have this voltage variation that will be sent to the controller, and the controller will turn the motor based on how much did you twist the throttle. Okay, now let's simulate a cable broke. I will remove one cable of the throttle and then we will see what will happen. Okay, basically it's very normal. We have 0 volts here, cable is loose, so we have a broke failure in the cable, in the wiring. As you can see, if I twist the throttle, nothing happened. We don't have any change of voltage, And as well in the e-bike LCD display, we have one error code. The symptoms could be very obvious. The e-bike will not move, but if you have this fault in the LCD display, you can troubleshoot and you can understand where is the fault, because the fault could be in the motor, could be in the controller. But with this information, you can check in your manual of your e-bike or LCD manual. Then you can understand that E34 means that you have error in the throttle. Then you can go directly to the throttle and or replace all the throttle or replace only the Hall effect sensor, because the magnet will not be an issue. What could be the problem will be the Hall effect sensor or some cable broke. Okay, so once I connect back the wiring, when I connect back the wiring of the Hall effect sensor, I have almost 0.8 volts, and then we have the normal condition of the e-bike display. So I believe that this could be useful for you, because the issue in the throttle is the most common in the e-bikes. And if you know how the throttle works, you can have a more precise troubleshooting, and then you can fix more easily your e-bike putting back to work. So that's it for the video. I hope this video will be useful for you. If yes, please consider to subscribe, and see you in the next video.